And this is going to be their chance. We're actually going to head into one of my favorite matchups, possibly one of the longest as well. And it's going to be on a map, well, a map that someone was looking forward to seeing earlier in chat. So hopefully they do enjoy this game now. I'm going to load up the replay and then we can get ready to go in.
And I'm going to spam refresh on the custom games list so that I can join as quickly as possible.
There we go,
I'm hosting. Alright. And Cadenzi's most important piece of micro is how quickly she can set her latency to extra high as soon as we get into the game.
That would
I'm an expert in that by now.
It is. You know what? I'm actually surprised how little it is lagging. Like, I remember trying to watch a replay with someone from America on IC Cup once, and we couldn't even watch on fastest, it was way too laggy. Which is just kind of crazy.
I was supposed to work on the BSL finals with Young Zero the other night, but unfortunately, doing live games is still not something that intercontinental distances allow. So I'm happy that this is from replays, but it is telling that even replays are having a few struggles here and there.
They are sometimes, so let's head on over to the overlay. Let's have a look at who our next two players are going to be. And let's get ready with our next game. I mean, we're in the game already, and I'm ready. So let's introduce it, and let's get going. Okay. So, as we see here on the overlay, fighting for White Clan, it's going to be another debut performance from them. It's going to be Leffe. Not Leffen from Sweden, the Smash player, but it is Leffe. I don't know if I'm saying this name right, maybe Leff. But he is a Terran, and he is going to be up against... Okay, yeah, it is going to be what I think it is. Okay, he is going to be up against Toker, the Terran player from Sisorm. I think I got Marine and Toker's races around the wrong way or something. I'm going to have to fix that for next time, but... is the first cast of round two, so I expected at least one thing to go wrong, and luckily enough it is only this, because I did completely break my overlay throughout the break.
And you weren't late this time on the cast.
I know.
Pretty impressive.
That is crazy, like I'm always late by like 5-10 minutes, but I was ready, everyone was ready, it was great. It was a good start.
Yeah, so Leffe is a premium brand of Belgian beer. Very popular out here in Korea.
I was going to say it sounds French, but I guess it's Belgian.
I mean, it's almost French.
I mean, we speak French and Belgian, so...
Okay,
and German and Dutch, but, yeah.
Now, the map they are going to be playing on this time is going to be New Sniper Ridge. Now, this was a map from 2010. It evolved from Sniper Ridge, which was ever so slightly different. One of the major differences is, as you can see, the Hindu or Buddhist swastika. Can't remember the name of the proper name for the actual symbol. I don't want to say the wrong thing. I said the wrong thing already. Either way, the third base, like, that was actually... joined up on both sides, so made it a little bit easier to defend the third, so I think that was why they changed that. But a lot of good maps, or a lot of good games on this map. We had an insane ZVZ on this map in the Clash for Char, and it's a really fun map for TBT.
Indeed. This is actually the first map I ever played against you, Kex, where
really?
We were playing in Rookie Team League 1, I think it was.
The funny thing is, I can't remember that at all. Like, you said that I played you in Rookie Team League and I had no idea.
It was one of the earliest matches, maybe like week one or something.
It's probably because I like blocked out the loss, because I was like, well, I'm never going to have to play this person again.
Yeah,
and then here we are!
You time in, where you just like, you wait until like your entire base is dead and you had like two Valkyries flying around. It was pretty funny.
Well, I like to put on a show, you know? You never know what's going to happen. As long as you got an SCV and a CC, you can come back, and that is why I love TBT. Because, like, there's a fantastic TBT that happened recently on Neo Ground Zero. If you've not seen it, it was from the Mu Pro League Finals. and it was between Sharp and Flash, so do go and watch that. But that is literally the epitome of why I love this matchup, and I'm hoping the game here is going to be as good as that. So let's move on over to the game, and let's have a look at who is going to win in this TBT between Leffe and Tucker.
And here we are, as if by magic.
Okay, and one of you start in the top right this time.
Okay, sick. I got this. In the upper right, in the yellow, playing for Psystorm, it is not 1a2a3a, but it is Tokka.
Yeah, he's called 1a2a3a, but he's got another name, which is Tokka, which is a lot easier to say.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's so that when his opponents read his name, they lose brain cells and are then easier to beat.
Very smart strategy, and probably utilizing the other side of that strategy is Leffe, the red Terran in the bottom right corner, playing for white.
He hopes that his name reminds them that they want to go grab a beer while they play, and then, you know, are much easier to beat, or more difficult, as the case may be.
You know, one of the important things here is they've actually spawned in vertical positions. Now, obviously positions do come into it a lot on every single matchup, but one of the biggest and one of the most positional, well, I think it probably is the most positional matchup in the entirety of Brood War, is Terran versus Terran. And the reason why is when you're in these vertical positions, it makes it a lot easier to actually split the map entirely in two horizontally. So I'm not sure if we will see that, or if we will see some aggression coming out from either player, but it looks like we will have a barracks coming down from Leffe.
That's a very odd choice of building. Normally you would want to start with a supply depot, and then a supply depot, and then another supply depot, right?
That is the ultimate TBT strat, just don't build anything but depots. Tokar actually built his barracks one later. He's done the thing you can do in TBP where you build the barracks and the gas at exactly the same time. Now, I believe it's so it times out your first upgrade almost perfectly when the machine shop finishes, but I can never remember exactly why. But Leffe, of course, is, with his positioning, going to be able to scout a little bit later as well. Other than Tokka is with his barracks, because Tokka's is right by his ramp.
Yeah, and so Leffe is scouting the incorrect direction, whereas I think... Sorry, was that what you were going to say, Cadenzi?
I know, I was going to say, I thought the when you get your gas, that sometimes your barracks, it gives you 100 gas by the time your barracks finishes, and that's the reason to do it.
Oh, Tokka got duped there.
Dude, that was a sick mind game.
Leffe actually went into the middle to scout for the proxy, but it worked out in his favor.
But that also, like, you really mind-gamed him, because when Leffe came out of the middle, it looked like his SCV was coming from the lower left-hand corner. And Tokka, like, misinterpreted that, and now is going to scout the wrong direction, whereas I think he was maybe going the right direction down to the bottom right-hand side. So that's really cool. I didn't expect to see that.
Yeah, now this is a bit unfortunate for Tokka as well, because where is he going to scout next? It looks like he's going to the top left. And he is going to scout absolutely last, so he will not know that his opponent is going for a very quick expansion.
Yeah, and he got fully scouted himself, so his opponent's going to be fully ready for everything that's coming.
You know, we do have that one factory expand coming up for Tokka and one Rax expand coming up for Leffe, but one Rax FE, if it's unscouted, is arguably one of the strongest builds in TBT. The only stronger one is 14cc, but this is going to be very hard for Tokka to punish this now, especially as he's scouting him, like, dead last.
Yeah, also, if he had gotten proxied in a different location other than the middle, he'd just be, like, really dead right now.
Yeah, he only actually built one Marine. Like, usually you would see two in TBT, just to kind of help defend the ramp a little bit against the SCV, but he will have one Marine, one Vulture. That will keep him alive, will allow him to stop this scaling SCV as well. But Leffe is going to see that there is actually an expansion here, which is a pretty big deal.
Yeah, I mean, that's really not all the scouting information you want, but it does tell you where your opponent's sunk a bunch of resources. I mean, you see the vultures out in the front, so you know nothing like super crazy is going on, but I mean, Leffe should be pretty ahead with that earlier expansion timing, right?
He is, and the other thing is, because you get the earlier expansion, you actually get the minerals quick enough to build the second factory faster, which is one of the crazy things about 1rax FE. Like, you get everything ever so slightly faster when you go for factory expand. Now, the one weakness it does have, especially on this map, as there is this high ground outside the front, if Toka had actually opted to rush Siege off of one base, then he'd actually be in a little bit of trouble, but he should be safe now.
Yeah, so what are the follow-ups here, do you think? Do you think he's going to go mass vultures of like four factories or something?
It looks like Leffe is probably going to go for mass vultures. He's built his three factories already. There are a few things you can do with this. You can either go into it's very important to get an armory around 5 minutes, 6 minutes, just to make sure you don't take a lot of damage to wraiths, but looks like Joker is going to go into vultures as well, but of course he is going to be a little bit further behind, just because his factories are later. Both of them are probably going to go up to five factories shortly though. That is the standard.
But one of them is going mines, and the other one is going vulture speed, and vultures do not care about mines, so that could work out against them.
Yeah, the important thing of going for mines first though is you do get control of this high ground. And if they do go tanks, it gives you the vision mainly as the main purpose, but Tokra is going to need to make sure he uses these mines properly. You need to spread them out, you need to use them for the map vision, or you could be in a lot of trouble, and he needs to get back and defend as well. This is going to be six vultures against I think it's going to be five, but here we go. Tokra will see these vultures leaving. Now, will he try and go for a counterattack here, or is he going to go back to defend? But Toka needs to pull back to his right.
Oh, the Marines have left the bunker.
Yeah, oh wow. I did not expect that. So really all there is up at the front is an unsieged tank and a couple vultures. So if he wanted to run by, he could. But instead, oh no, he actually catches Toka's vultures in the middle of the map. And that means that, what is this, 9 vultures to 2 or something? It's just crazy.
Yeah,
and there's speed vultures.
Yeah, this is one of those awkward situations where it can really, really go badly. We should have mines finishing up soon for Leffe as well. Just gonna double check that. Yeah, they should be finishing soon. And going for tanks isn't the best thing you can do, but he is building a wall with his buildings. But is it gonna be enough? The vultures are gonna get by. There's nothing to stop the ramp. Oh,
and
there we go.
Kill everything.
This is 12 vultures and everything's going to explode. Like, thankfully SCVs don't set them off, but like, yeah, that's just quite a few vultures. And so now all the tech that Toka has is totally useless because mines just don't do anything, and now all of his SCVs dies to vultures. GG. Wow, that was
LG.
Okay, well, yeah, only 1G.
That was a...
It was only half of a good game.
Yeah, that was a very, very clinical victory there by Leffe, and it really does show the difference that build order can make in TBT. Like, Leffe was able to produce off of the three factories. He was able to get the two factories as well. Now the trouble is, Toka just had his units out position. Now the one thing that he could have done differently, which would have changed absolutely everything, is by just leaving his tanks on the ramp. He would have had to pull his SCVs back from his natural, but that's not a huge deal. But his extra factories were late. He went for a very quick armory, but didn't really get to make use of it either. So a little bit unfortunate for him.
Yeah, he's kind of stockpiling money a little bit, wasn't he?